I know. Most of us are desperate to head somewhere tropical, grab our laptops, sit in the sun, enjoying pina coladas while working away on our laptops. However, please don't be one of those people that thinks you can sneakily do it without informing your boss, because honestly, you could end up losing your job and that thing that gave you the resources to be able to work abroad in the first place. So welcome to today's video, which is going to be our re-emergent theme of Work Abroad Wednesdays. I used to host this on my old channel called Dels Ogun, which is still there. But since this channel is solely focused on career development, progress, acceleration, I figured I'd move it over here as well. So it fits that in today's episode, we're talking about something that is a big topic right now, especially as it is the pandemic and some of us are desperate to break out of lockdown in due course. But do things the right way, because you don't want to end up in a situation where the government comes after you, but not just you, but also your company. So we're going to get into that in a minute. But if you're new to this channel, my name is Dels. This is the Career Game Changer channel, where I'm all about helping ambitious high achievers to transition from jobs that they no longer enjoy into new careers or businesses that they love anywhere in the world, hence the Work Abroad Wednesday. So I basically have worked all over the place, like from London, Dubai, Paris, and I'm very, very passionate about helping people build international careers. That is my jam. And that's why I know that you want to make sure that you do not subject yourself and your boss to a crazy amount of tax just because you did not ask for permission. Yes, I know it's really annoying, and especially if you work in a 9-to-5, the fact that you have to ask for holidays, the fact that you can't just get up and go, you're doing your job. You've already shown that you can do it from home and you don't have to be in the office. So why do you have to ask for permission? Why don't you just do it and then ask for forgiveness later? Well, one of the key reasons why it's important for you not to do this and to find a way to speak to your boss is because, I've already hinted on this, tax. But let's talk about your boss for one. I guess what happens with companies is that in certain jurisdictions, I give you an example, like Dubai, for example, if you go there and you start working and you work there for an extensive amount of time, it could be said that your company is operating from that jurisdiction because you're an employee, especially if you're a 9-to-5er and not a consultant, which means that if your company is found to be operating in that jurisdiction, then they have to pay taxes there. And yes, I know you want to think about sneaking and doing it, but I'm sure you know by now that IT are monitoring your computer and they can usually tell where you are based on the IP addresses that are going to be tracked when you move to a new country. So it's very, very important for you to bear this in mind. Also, yes, going back to my example of Dubai doesn't charge personal income tax. But if you are working from some other jurisdictions, you are going to be breaking the law if you're there for 3, 4, 5 months without paying any income taxes to the government. I think it's so important to do the right thing. Yes, to be honest, I'm not going to pretend that I'm an angel here, but with things like this that can have a massive level of impact on your income, your job security, I mean, to be honest, you probably won't have a job at all when your company find out, then I think the best approach is for you to actually ask for permission. That said, the events of the past few years have shown that we are more than capable of working from home, and all you have to do is prepare a proposal for your boss showing a clear reason why you should be permitted to work abroad, what value it brings, how it's not going to affect your job, and more than likely, the company is going to allow you to do it. However, if they don't, and it's so important for you to work somewhere else because you want a break, then you can apply for another job. This is one of the main premises of the Career Game Changer program. Like, there's no reason for you to be stuck. You are not a tree. There are so many multinational companies that are hiring. So why do you want to stay doing what you're doing instead of going and asking for something better that's more in alignment with what you want for yourself? So this is a very short video today. It's basically the introduction to Work Abroad Wednesdays. Follow me on Instagram at Dels Ogun. And just giving you the heads up that there's going to be more of this coming. Work Abroad Wednesdays is going to be a thing. It's re-emerging. So I'm going to link all of the previous Work Abroad Wednesday videos below this one. So check them out. Get started, start building your knowledge, because if you want to build an international career, this is a great place to be. So thank you guys for sticking around, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.